Why hello, Angela, and welcome to my kitchen. Tonight's menu is a Thai curry stew, courtesy of Trader Joe's green Thai curry sauce. I'm trying to be somewhat healthful, try not to eat so much carbohydrate late at night, where it turns into fat. And so I have a very low carb, high protein stew. I have broccoli, I have tofu and onion. I also have this special thing, it's a Japanese thing. It's called konnyaku. It's like a gelatinous, rubbery yam cake. It's very tasty, kind of crunchy, kind of reminds me of the texture of jellyfish, but it's very, very healthy. It's a Japanese diet food, sort of. A whole block of like this, it's only like 50 calories. So it's very filling, but not very caloric. I also have a tofu for protein, so I'm trying to get big and brawny. You can see my efforts here. Hopefully, very, very soon, I will be able to lift things over my head. Today, I have a lot of things going on, a lot of orientation things. I got to put out a fire today. We had fire extinguisher training, and there was a hands-on activity part of it, where they lit a gasoline fire, and you took the fire hose, and you put out the fire. I put out a fire. I'm a hero. Also, we had library orientation, which was a little strange. Learned some things about people that I didn't necessarily need to know at a library orientation of all things, but Berkeley. In other graduate school related news, I sent emails and I'm becoming much, much closer, very, very close to securing the lab that I want to work in, that I wanted to work in for almost the last, I don't know, year. So I'm very, very excited. But I'm not gonna jinx it because I really wanna work there. But it's making good progress. And I can tell you about that later. I saw this on Imgur and thought of you and me subsequently. And the answer to last week's Guess the Cover is Cat's Cradle by Kurt Vonnegut. Admittedly, I have never read that book. I only guessed it because I saw the Cat's Cradle on the cover and kind of Google searched my way to the answer. But I do believe it's one of the books that I should read and do intend to read, since it is about science and, you know, nuclear things and science fiction. And I like all those things. Speaking of good science-y books, recently I went to a 50 cents book sale here near campus, and at a strange bookstore that is slightly communistic, had a lot of Marx and Lenin stuff going on. I don't know if it was ironic, but they seemed very enthusiastic about it. But anyway, they were selling 50 cents books, and I can't give up that kind of deal. So I got some science books, because that's sort of all the stuff I read now. I have The Cosmic Blueprint, Richard Leakey's Origins Reconsidered. Since I don't know much about biology, and I'd like to learn more about what people think. Solar Energy Thermal Processes. I mostly got this just to laugh, because I'm sure a lot of stuff here is very, very outdated. I think it's from the 80s. And so that's just one of those. So I was thinking about books, because we're playing this book game, and I was wondering, should I not read science books, popular science books? Am I going to be too inundated with science stuff for my research and classes? Should I diversify, and should I have a little outlet, a little mental and intellectual outlet into something completely unrelated to science? I thought maybe, could be true. I do enjoy my outlets. And so, I brought from home one book that I think will help me through my hard times. Winnie the Pooh. I didn't buy this book. I wasn't even given this book. I stole it. I stole it from Yale. The summer after freshman year, I was staying on campus for the commencement musical, How to Succeed in Business Without Trying, without really trying. And I was staying in a dorm, one of the dorm rooms, and whoever had lived there previously had left a whole bunch of books in their bathroom, and they left Winnie the Pooh, so I stole it, because I wanted it, and no one else is taking it, so it's mine now. But Winnie the Pooh, I like it. I perhaps like this more than I do like the TV show, but the TV show is pretty good. Winnie the Pooh. I have to eat my dinner now before it gets too late and my body can't metabolize everything correctly. So I think that'll be pretty much it for today. I look forward to talking to you in person, on Skype, looking at your face. Other than that, have a wonderful day tomorrow. And here's this week's book, or here's today's book cover.